Within about a 1.5 kilometer radius of where we're standing right now, we have over $1.5 billion of research going on in the life sciences field every year.
So we are in the Max Bell building of the Toronto General Research Institute, which is affiliated with the University Health Network. The work that we do here is actually focused on cardiac repair and end-stage heart failure. We are actually looking at using animal models and disease modeling in a dish to try to come up with new treatments for this very devastating disease.
A couple of decades ago, if you were diagnosed with breast cancer, your chances of hitting that 5-year gold standard of good living was very, very low. Today it's at 88%. We thought for years that Hep C was incurable. There's now medication that cures it. We never would have believed that 5 years ago.
I think we've always been a leader in healthcare research and development and life sciences innovation. Hospice is a Canadian term. It started here. Insulin was discovered across the street. What we haven't been known for is actually then commercializing these discoveries and taking them globally.
We have a $52 billion business that runs our healthcare system in Ontario, and we should be leveraging the massive state investment in healthcare as an economic driver.
The reality is that health is expensive. We need to invest more and smarter in all of it, and part of that is by getting all of the different players involved in investing together.
We have money, a lot of money that's going into the system, so we have to ask ourselves the question, are we using it efficiently? I would say in the pharma industry, it's shocking how many new innovations are on the cusp of being made available, and yet we're held back.
We have between 800 and 1,000 startups in health technology that export their goods and services in healthcare around the world, but they don't grow as a result of this big $52 billion end user, the Ontario healthcare system. They kind of grow in spite of it.
If you think about innovation, there's the invention side, creating the companies. There's the adoption side, actually getting those innovations to the people who need them.
It's creating this ecosystem where people can collaborate, they can bring investors in, they can bring in mentorships, they can bring in support from the government. All those things come together to create great opportunities. Think about AI, artificial intelligence. We are the leaders in the world. What can AI do to life science industry? I think it's only up to the imagination, and we're harnessing that now.
Can we get governments, to work innovatively and collegially together for the betterment of all Canadians?
How do you enable and empower people to take control of their own health?
How do we keep the researchers in this country?
It is an opportunity for us to show companies around the world that we're open for business. We really have a diversity here, we have lower taxes, we have a safe environment to work in. Those are all things that attract CEOs from around the world.
It's another great opportunity in Canada to reverse the brain drain and change it into a brain gain. You will have people living and working and playing and investing and raising families in these cities, provinces, in this country for the next 100 years.